We will discuss the difference between force and torque in the series of translational and rotational dynamics. This is we call the force, which we call the linear force, and this is the rotational force, or the rotational analog of force we call as torque. Now first let's understand what is force. Force we define as this is the rate of change of linear momentum, and we write this thing in a derivative form. If the change is very small, then if time is going to be very less, or the change to be going very less, then we write that this is dp by dt. Now what is p here? P is the linear momentum, which is equal mv, and m we call the mass, which is a material property which we will discuss more in detail. This is mass. Mass is a material property, and we write this is F equals d over dt of p, and p is mv. Now both m and v are depending on time, so we will use the product rule, and the product rule is m dv over dt plus v dm over dt. If we will have a situation that in that situation the mass will not be depending on time, then we will say that this component is going to zero, and F is equal to m dv over dt, and I can further write that this is dv over dt is the linear acceleration, so this is ma. So I have came to the Newton's second law of motion, that force is equal to mass time acceleration. And now I can write this one is acceleration is force over mass. Acceleration is directly proportional to force and inversely proportional to mass. If for a given force, if mass will be more, then it will gain less acceleration. So it gives us the idea that mass is actually showing a resistance role to acceleration. So I can write that mass is the resistance. Mass is the resistance to linear motion. And now we discuss what is torque. So for torque I can also call is angular force, because this is the rotational dynamics. This is actually angular force. I know that torque is written as R cross F, but I also know that according to this definition, if linear force is the rate of change of linear momentum, then I can write that this torque is the rate of change of angular momentum. Now angular momentum is L is equal to R cross P, the linear momentum, and this L will become Rp sine of the angle, and the maximum angular momentum will be R times P. So I can not right that tau is equal to d over dt of L, and this is equal to d over dt of Rp, and I can further write the tau is d over dt d over dt for R. Now for P I can write M and V. So this is R times M times V, and I will have to convert the things to the from V to I will have to convert V to omega as well, and from earlier calculations we know that V is equal to R omega. So this is R times M and this is R omega. Now this torque is equal to d over dt, and this is mr square and omega. Now I know here that as we consider m over there independent of time, so we consider this one independent of time. R is also not depending on time, only omega is depending on time. So I will write that this is mr square and d omega over dt. Now I define this mr square with a physical quantity that I call I, and it is the moment of inertia. The moment of inertia I, and this I is means if we are having the mass not uniformly distributed, then we will consider the center of mass, summation on I running from 1 up to n, and this is mirI squared. So we will not go further into moment of inertia, but we will have to write that tau is equal to I times, and d omega over dt is actually equal to alpha, the angular acceleration. Now look at this equation, that this is F equals ma, so tau is equal I times alpha. Now the role which is played by m in linear dynamics or translational dynamics is played by I in rotational dynamics. So I can write this one is alpha is equal to tau over I. Now here alpha is the angular acceleration. More the force will be, more will be the angular acceleration, and this moment of inertia, which I can also call as the angular mass. The angular mass is playing a resistive role, so I can restate for the angular dynamics or rotational dynamics that angular mass is playing the role of resistance to angular motion. So I can write that moment of inertia is the resistance to angular motion. As that was to linear motion, this one is to angular motion. So I can say that this m I can call is inertial mass, And this I will call is angular mass, because it is playing the role of angular mass. So moment of inertia or angular mass is actually the rotational dynamics mass, and this one is the linear acceleration mass. So FEA equals that, and here alpha equals this, and these two equations, this equation which is the tau is equal to the I times alpha, means force, rotational force is equal to the rotational mass or the angular mass times the angular acceleration, and linear force is equal to linear mass times linear acceleration. So these are having some similarities. We measured this F in Newton, and here we will measure this torque in Newton into meter. So this is measured in Newton into meter. Now Newton into meter we call work, but that is in linear dynamics. Here we will not call this work, because this meter dimension is actually due to the rotational analog and not due to the like as we have this thing in force. So I can write that E is equal to F over M, in the same sense alpha is equal to tau over I, and here P is equal to M times V, and here L is equal for M, I will write, means as I write for P I write the angular momentum, for M the angular mass, and for V the angular velocity. So L is equal to I omega as well. So the role which is played by mass here is played by the moment of inertia in angular dynamics, and that's the difference.